operator to 9S.
This is 9S. Go ahead.
I have an incoming message for 2B and 9S from the commander. Initiating playback. 2B, 9S. We've lost contact with several Yorha units that were on their way to the surface. Their black boxes are online, so we presume they're still alive. We've tracked the location of their signals, so I need all Yorha units on the surface to head over and investigate. End transmission.
I heard something about that back at the Resistance camp.
Target location confirmed. I'm worried about the other androids. We should probably check this out as soon as possible. The whole place is like a giant machine's nest. I wonder what it used to be like.
Accessing historical records. Analysis. This location was once used for weapons production and experimentation.
No kidding? What kind of weapons?
Humanoid combat robots. Common examples include the P-22 and P-33 models.
Human-shaped weapons, huh? Wonder if they worked like flight units.
Unknown. No image-based information exists.
I think I can access the data over there. There we go. That's what 210 wanted. Now I just have to send it to her.
Alert. Poor reception in this area is preventing data upload. Proposal. Unit 9S should move to an area with better reception.
Got it.
This should be good enough. Pod, upload that data to Operator 210.
Affirmative.
Operator 210 to 9S, come in.
This is 9S.
I received the data you sent. It's fascinating. It appears to be the journal of a human who once worked in the factory.
What, like a diary?
Yes. According to this, the man worked long hours on an almost daily basis. He says, and I quote, "They're working me like a machine. Working like a machine to build a machine?" Humans truly were strange creatures.
Sounds like it.
I'll send you a reward later.
Wait, I can get rewarded for doing this?
I didn't say you would not get a reward.
No, but... Hey, don't disconnect me.
Report. Mail notification received from access point.
Yeah. Looks like our surface route's been cut off. Maybe we can get through from underground. So 2B, those machines out in the desert look just like androids, right?
Right.
But we androids were modeled after our human creators. So why would machines try to look like us?
There's no point trying to work out unsolvable problems.
I suppose.
This is Tactical Support Unit Pod 042. Control has been assigned to 2B.
This is Tactical Support Unit Pod 153. Control has been assigned to 9S.
Combat data exchange requested.
Exchange accepted.
Proposal. Data should be exchanged regularly for greater efficiency.
Proposal accepted. Data will be exchanged regularly for greater efficiency.
End communication.
Thank you. were found by the machines. The machines called them treasures. Each treasure had a different shape. Each treasure had a different shape.
What are those? What the?
This is weird.
Let's be happy together, together, together.
Where does this corridor lead? Getting resistance signals from that building over there.
We need a way through.
Let's look around for a route we can take.
Huh?
Let's sing.
These machines are heavily armed. We'll regret it later if we let them escape. So let's take them out.
What's this? Some kind of crystal?
Analysis. It is a core fragment from the machine life form. It is similar in structure to a plant cell.
A plant cell? What's this?
Analysis. It is a device that propels humans on rails at high speeds for the purposes of amusement. It was commonly referred to as a roller coaster.
Humans sure are strange creatures. Hey, 2B?
Yes?
People who know me well usually call me Nines, so... So what do you think? I mean, if you want to call me Nines, it's totally okay.
I'm there.
All right.
Resistance members detected beneath this room.
Our records don't say anything about a machine like this. It's trying to hack us! If we take hacking damage, it'll affect our bodies as well! Tubi!
Beautiful! Beautiful! I must be beautiful!
Those look like corpses!
Are we seriously being attacked with dead androids?
Wait, I don't think... 2B! I'm detecting black box signals! They aren't dead. They've been turned into weapons!
Oh, this ends now.
Analyze the enemy's hacking pattern. I'm going to try to hack it back. Keep it busy.
You got it.
Saturation attack triggered by enemy consciousness data. Failure to destroy it quickly may lead to serious damage in memory regions.
Pod!
Affirmative.
Go! Thanks for the assist.
Oh, you mean the hacking? No worries. Us scanners are pretty good at that kind of thing. I've got your back anytime.
We have to save those androids.
I'm sorry, 2B. Their circuits are fried. I think they were only being kept alive by that enemy.
Oh.
So.
What is it?
That machine had some pretty weird things to say, huh? It's almost like it had actual emotion.
The machines don't have feelings. You said that yourself.
Yeah, I guess. This thing is awfully verbose for a machine.
We repay you. Come to our village.
It could be a trap. Still, we should at least head over there and gather data, right?
Material obtained.
Thank you.
What's that?
Oh, right. You wouldn't have seen that before. They're sending supplies up from Earth to the moon in the bunker. There are no spare parts or fuel in space, after all.
Huh. So why don't the machines, or the aliens who created them, attack the bunker directly? They originally came here from outer space, right?
Well, there are a few theories about that, but no one knows for sure. Hard to tell what an alien is thinking, you know?
Brother? Why do we have to wear undergarments? It's such a hassle.
The records claim humans covered their crotches as they went about their business. Revealing one's genitals was seen as problematic. So just be quiet and wear them already.
Okay. But why are we eating this plant matter? Machines don't need to eat things like this.
This is a type of fruit. Our data suggests that mankind gained great intelligence from consuming fruit. So quit griping and eat it already.
All right, if that's what you want. But once we're done, can we play together for a bit?
Fine.
Oh, great. Then I'll eat lots of fruit.
They all have white flags.
Looks like they really don't want to fight.
Hello. Before we begin, there's something you must understand. We are not your enemies.
2B, we can't trust anything the machines say.
I understand that you see us as the enemy, but... Well, anyway, my name is Pascal. I'm the leader of this village. Those who reside here desire nothing more than to live a peaceful existence. Look around for yourself. You'll see that it's true.